And the angels began to teach the woman of earth charms and spells and the cutting of roots, and made them acquainted with plants. And the woman became pregnant, and it gave birth to large giants, whose height was 3,000 cubits. The giants consumed all the work and toil of men, and when men could no longer sustain them, the giants turned against them and devoured mankind. And they began to sin against birds and beasts, the reptiles and fish, and to devour one another's flesh, and drank the blood. Then the earth laid accusation against the lawless ones, and Azazel taught men to make swords and knives, shields, breastplates, taught them about the metals of the earth and the art of working them, and bracelets and ornaments, and the use of antimony, and the beautifying of the eyelids, and all kinds of precious stones, and all coloring and dyes. And there was great impiety. They turned away from God and committed fornication, and they were led astray and became corrupt in all their ways. Shemjazah taught the casting of spells and root cuttings. Amaros taught counterspells, or the release from spells. Berekijil taught astrology. Kokobel taught the constellations, the portents, prophesying, and omens. Ezekiel, the knowledge of the clouds. Erechiel, the signs of the earth. Shamzi, the signs of the sun. And Seiriel, the course of the moon. This is what happened during the great fall, when the angels fell from heaven, desiring after woman, teaching them secrets behind the curtains of heaven to become gods on earth. Shemjazah was Azazel's subordinate, an appointed chieftain. God created Shemjazah with the gift of sorcery and spells in order to rule over his subordinates. Azazel gifted with the knowledge of cosmetics, crystals, gems, metal manipulation, and warfare. Being the first angel to fall from heaven and the head chief of those angels that preceded him thereafter, would later go down in history to be called Satan. This is the origin of witchcraft.